Hello guys, it is DLC Software. Welcome back to a new episode of Building the Diamond Minecraft Lab. Today we're going to make the satellite, which is outside as you can see. You can see some blocks over there, which is like the location where I need to put it. Let me first quickly explain something to you guys. As you can see, there's no hills over here because I'm not going to make the full hills biome in this tutorial series. Next episode, or actually the last episode, so episode 25, I'm going to do a little bit of the biome around here, but I'm not going to do the full mountains. So if you do want to make the mountains, I would say do them first and then make the satellite, because I'm going to build them on the ground over here. But if you're building mountains, it's of course a little bit higher up, so then you would have to make it, like for example, over here a little bit. So I'm going to show you how to make the satellite dish, and I'm going to build it right over there on the ground, which is like the location where it is, but then not in the height. But if you really want to make it on the hills, you want to make the hills first, of course, because that's more important. So that block over there is where the position is for the normal one, so it is in the length and in the width where it's going to be, but not, like I already said, how high it's going to be. So yeah, it's going to start off right over here with the helicopter platform, as you can see, and then the over here, the left upper corner, then that block over here. I believe it's 40 blocks to the front from here, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, sorry, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 20, 31, 32, 33, 34, 35, 36, 37, 38, 39, yeah, there we go, 40 blocks to the front. And then I believe it's 10 blocks that way. So we go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Alright, so once you get there, let me quickly get rid of this block, this is necessary. This is the starting block. As you can see, it's not the right block, but it's like the place where the block needs to be. So what you want to get yourself to start off is some stone bricks, as well as some cobblestone walls, some normal stone, some stone slabs, some stone brick stairs, some iron fences, ladders as well, some glowstone. Alright, there we go, that's okay for now, unless I miss a block. We will see it in a second if that's the case. And then the first thing you want to do is of course replace this for a stone brick. Then you also want to place one right over there. Then from this block you want to go 1, 2, 3, 4 to the right, and then make like the opposite of that. Then we go around a little bit. So you have like this block which goes diagonal that way, and then you want to skip two blocks diagonal, which leaves you at the third block. So that means 1, 2, 3. As you can see, there's two blocks of space diagonal between it. And that means that you also want to have your block over there like that. Then we must again go 1, 2, 3, 4, and we place our block over there. Then we go up diagonal once, and skip two blocks diagonal, and then at the third one, place your new block. Then we place one over there again. Then we go 1, 2, 3, 4. And we place our next one. Then one diagonal to the right. Then 1, 2, 3 diagonal. And this again, 1, 2, 3, 4. And then one over there. And that's how it should look in the end. If it's right, let me quickly make sure it is. Yeah, probably is. So between those blocks, there's three blocks of space. And between the diagonal ones, there's two blocks of space. Now we're going to extend these things six times. So that means 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So let's do that on each one. Oh, whoops. Already messing up over there. Alright, so everything is now 7 blocks long, as you can see. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And then we're going to do like 4 of these cobblestone walls on top of them. So 1, 2, 3, 4. And that for each one. Alright, and there we go. So then we're going to get ourselves a stone. And we're going to connect the ones which aren't diagonal. So the right ones over here. Like this. Alright, there we go. So then you have two left on each side, that one and that one. What you want to do is you want to place 1, 2, 3, and 1, 2, 3 on each one. So you get like a little bit of a round corner effect. So here as well, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. Alright, and there we go. So now what we need to do is we need to fill this up. And we also need to extend it once. So what I would like to do is first extend it once. And then you need to just like fill up both of the layers. So I will do that off camera because it takes quite some time. And I will see you guys in a second. Alright, and there we go. As you can see, it's now filled up, as well the first layer as the second one. Now what we need to do is we need to find the middle, and I don't know if it's smart to do it from the bottom or from the top. I think the bottom. So what you need to do is you just need to pick one of those sides, which is not diagonal. So this one, for example, doesn't matter which one. Then you get the middle block. You have 1, 2, 3, and the second one is the middle one. Then you count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, I believe it's 7. No, 8 blocks to the middle. And that's basically where you need to like fly up and then get rid of the blocks. And as you can see, that's exactly the middle. So like quickly fly up. There we go. As you can see, that's the middle. Then what we do is like the side of the lab, which is this side for me, this side. That's where you want to go to the back. So then this means this is the back side. And at that point, what you want to do is make the like the hole over here go to the ground. Because there's going to be a ladder over there. As you can see over there. So from the lab point over here, it's the staircase should be visible, the ladders. So if you're like, for example, building it that way, then it's wrong. Whoops, almost. So annoying this. Okay, there we go. Beautiful. So then the next thing we do is in each corner of those 5 light blocks, so if 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, in each corner of that, you want to place 2 of those full stone slabs. 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, yeah, like that. Alright, there we go. And then on top of that, we place some stone brick stairs. Alright. Behind these stairs, what you want to do is place 5 of those stone slabs again. So it will look like this. You want to do it on each side, of course. Pretty much everything you do is on each side, except for when we get to the actual satellite. But the whole tower is like pretty much all the same at each point. Okay, there we go. So then we also place some stonework stairs beneath those slabs. Right, and then we get ourselves some more slabs, which we will then place like this. So 2 over there and also 2 on the other side. So you get this nice corner effect once again. So let's do it on the other side as well, because like I said, it's on each side. Right, there we go. This is how it looks from the top, just if you're wondering. Then we get ourselves, oh, we already had some iron bars, by the way. That's not necessary. The iron bars. And what you need to do is, first of all, you need to connect those to each other. It's actually pretty much all you need to do. It's like you need to go to the above the edge. It's where you need to place off your bars. That, and there we go. Then we also place them in those corners over here. go. Then what we do is we get ourselves some more stone slabs, and we extend the stone slab with the staircase in front of it two times. So one, two, one, two for each side. Go, crank it outside. Oh, they're so annoying. I literally just like ran into my house with a bike. I started screaming all over the place. They're just so brutal and annoying. It's insane. I hope you guys are like that, my subscribers. I'm pretty sure you guys have more manners. It's really insane. Okay, so on top of these stone slabs, you also want to place your stairs, just like we did down there. There we go. Then we get ourselves some stone and we connect them just like we did over here, but then with stone instead of stone slabs. Okay, that one was a bit messed up. There we go. And now we connect those diagonally, so that means... Oh, oops. Like that. Okay, that's really hard to see, I'm sorry. No one's getting rid of the corners, by the way. That's how you want to connect them. You need to fill it up in the end anyway, so it doesn't really matter if you have it like that or like that, because in the end you should fill it up anyway. Okay, so let's quickly do that, and then I will show you the end result. Alright, there we go. Is this right? Yeah, okay, there we go. So in each corner, as you can see, it's now diagonally done. So we have a bit of like an 8 square. Is that how you call it? No, I'm not sure. 8 shape, something like that. Then we get ourselves a new block, which is the... Where is it? Cyan stained clay block. We also actually need something else. So we can get rid of the iron bars. And instead, what you want to get yourself is some stone brick slabs. So the cyan stained clay is pretty much one layer inside of the other one, as you can see. Just one layer smaller. Like that. You could fill it up if you want. Oh no, you actually don't have to fill that up. I'm sorry. What you want to do is you want to go ahead and get to that staircase, which is over here, and then you want to extend it. Which means you also need to smash a hole over there again. And also, of course, make the actual staircase. There we go. So then this is basically like the second floor where you can watch the lab. Which looks really epic from this side, by the way, in my opinion. Then what we do is we place the stone brick slabs a half block above the other ones. Above the stone bricks. And the stone block... No, just the stone blocks. Alright, and above that what we do is we build some stone slabs. Alright, and then for each corner, you also need to add one little block. Just so you know. Okay, there we go. It's coming along pretty nice already. Almost time for the actual satellite. So now we're going to do a few little spires, which are leading to the satellite, and then we're ready to go. So those spires, how shall I start them? Okay, so the lab is over there, as you can see in the back. Which means that in this corner, you want to have your blocks like that. And on that corner as well. So this is how the block should be, if the lab is on that side. Then what we do, is we place stone brick stairs over there. So in the corner of the corner. Alright, like that. Then like this. Then next to that, you want to get yourself some stone. Oh, oops. Right, there we go. Then you want to extend that once. Stone. And then you also want to extend them one time to the inside. So this is how it looks so far. No, wait a second, by the way. No, never mind. That's right, that's right. Okay, then you once again go to the inside once. So I make a little bit of a turn over there. Then that block has to be extended up. It also has to be getting a stone brick stair next to it. Alright, so there we go. This is how it looks. Okay, then the two in front over there, actually the back for us. So those two are ready now. Yeah, like that. The ones in the back over here, not. Sorry. What you need to do is get yourself some stone. Then we go diagonally up, like that. And then we extend it three times. One, two, three. One, two, three. Alright. So that's done. Now what you need to do is you need to get the cobblestone wall. Like we extend the staircase over here. Now what you want to do is go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 times up. Like that. Okay, so everything is now done. Now it's time to get onto the actual satellite dish. It's pretty easy, but it's just a bit hard to see where it gets started, because that really doesn't matter. So I clear my inventory. The blocks that we'll mainly be needing for now are iron, clay, and block of quartz. We'll also be needing some other blocks, like for example stone, a cobblestone wall as well, I believe, redstone repeater, levers, probably something else as well, but we'll see that in a second. So the first thing we do is we place a block of quartz above the wait a second, by the way. Something is not right about this. Wait, give me a second. Alright, so I found out what I did wrong. Also, I found out that I missed some glowstone, which is also pretty important. So first of all, this stone thing over here, let's cover up the block of quartz, actually needs to go to the middle over here. Like that. That's where it should be. So let me quickly get rid of it. Over there. And then you need to find the middle, which was over here, and then we need to extend it 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 times, like that. Then there was also some glowstone, which I forgot about. And the glowstone is going to be right over here. So basically next to these corner blocks out of sandstone clay. They're also down here. Wait, did I already do them over there? Yes. And they're also over here. And they're like, you have these diagonal ones, and you need to find the middle of that. So as you can see, this hole over here goes in a straight line to that one, and also to that one. And that's where you want to have your glowstone. Also for this one, for example, that one goes in a straight line to that one. So that's where you want to have your second one. If that's a bit hard, what you can also do is go to the middle, and then you go 1, 2, 3, 4 up. And then 3 to each side. So for example, let's do it on the other side. You go 1, 2, 3, 4 up, and then 3 to the side. Then you once again go 1, 2, 3, 4 up, and then 1, 2, 3 to the side. And there you go. That's how the blocks should... No, wait, that's wrong. I'm sorry, it's actually 5. So you go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Like that. There we go, perfect. Okay, so let's go back to where we left off, which is right over here. Getting the block of quartz, which we place on top of the stone over here. Then we go up diagonally 1, 2, 3, 4 times. So we go 1, 2, 3, 4. We also go down once, like that. Now we, except for the top one over here, what we need to do is we need to extend this one, that one, that one, and that one. Also except for the bottom one, by the way. Let's get rid of the bottom one and the top one first. So this is what you'll have so far. No, and then one over here as well. This is what you'll have so far. These blocks will be extended 5 times each on each side. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5, 5, also on the other side. Alright, there we go. So that one is now done. Then what we do is we do another one over here. So you go to the middle and you add another one. This one has to be extended 3 times. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. Like that. Okay, then I think it's smart to start off right over there. So this one, which was 3-1 long, what you want to do is you want to build another layer on top of that, which is just one layer bigger. Like that. Then you go to each corner and you add 3 blocks next to it. Then the next layer is going to be 2. Next layer is going to be 3 again. This is how it looks so far. Then the next two layers are the same. So 1, 2. And 1, wow. 1 and 2. There we go. Then we place 2 blocks of iron, 2 blocks of irons over there. Like that. Also 1 diagonally. And 1 diagonally over there. Like that. Then on top of that we connect them with some clay. Alright. Layer of iron on top of that. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Just if you're wondering how many blocks it is. Okay, now you have a beautiful hole over here, which we're going to fill up. The first layer over here is going to be filled up with some iron. 1, 2, 3, 4. There's 5 in total, as you can see. It's also 1 block to the back. And the rest is pretty much all quartz. So that means that you need to build on that layer and then fill up the hole. Okay, and there we go, that's how it will look so far. Then the next layer is going to be right over here. Starting off over there, so we do 3 over here. 1, 2, 3. Then 2. 1, 2. Then another 2. Another 2, and then 1, 1. Also on the other side. 3. 2. 2. 2. 2. There we go, and then 1, 1. So this is how it looks. Over there. Whoa, we're pretty far away from that point already. Insane. Great. Okay, so then the top will be done in a second. I will just first do the block of quartz part, and then the rest. So now that we've got this part, I'm gonna go back, because over here it gets a little bit harder. Wait a second, my laptop is a bit out of balance. There we go. Okay, so this layer right over here. Yeah. Okay, let's go back to the top over here. You have this block over here. Then you want to go diagonal to the right ones. You want to go 4 down. 1, 2, 3, 4. On the second block over here, you also want to have a little extension. Then you want to go 2 down like that. And then 1 over there. So this is what you'll get. Also on the other side, let's start off from the bottom this time. 1 over there. Then 2 over there. And then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And 1 block over there as well. Okay, so that's now done. Then what we do, next thing. This is pretty pretty funny part. Let me check how many times. Okay, so now we're going to make a quite diagonal going triangle, if that makes any sense. So the first thing we do is we have this single block over here, this one I'm looking at, which we need to extend 1, 2, 3 times diagonally. Then we fill up the holes like this. You don't have to place the clay, by the way. Alright, there we go, that's how it will look. Then we do 2. And then for the end, 1. Alright, so that's how it will look. Let's also do the other side. So it's a bit complicated over here. 1, 2, 3. Which makes 4 in total. And then we do 3. Easy way to do this, by the way, is like you go on the insides over here and then place a layer beneath it. Then on the insides, a layer beneath it. and the inside layer beneath it. And then you get rid of the clay. And as you can see, that leaves us with that same shape. So then when that's done, what you want to do is over here, place a clay block and then go around it with the quartz, like this. Get rid of the clay. And then extend this corner 3 times, which leaves it on that point. That's how it'll look. Also on the other side. Clay lock over there. Build around it. Get rid of that one. Build up 3 times. Okay, there we go. So it's quite big already, by the way, which is great, but it's still not done. What we're now going to do is we're going back to this point. We're going to mirror that on the other side, like that. Then we place a block of iron on the right of that. And we go 3 down with quartz. Then 2 to the side. Then 2 beneath that. Then 1 beneath that. Yeah, let's leave it for like this for now. So there we go. Also on the other side. Over here. Just want to do place your block right there. Then go iron block to the left. Then 3 down. 1, 2, 3. Then 2 to the left. 2 beneath that and 1 beneath that. Okay, great. So then we go back. And we place, first of all, one little block over there. Also, one over there. And one over here. It's a bit random, as you can see. Then you go 2 over there and then extend it twice. Like this. Okay, then we go back to this side, do it again. So it was... one over there, one over there, and one over there, two like that, and then 2 like that. Okay, that's done as well. So then, what we need to do, I don't know what's smart to do, we also have the whole bottom left. Do we have a better screenshot of this maybe? Oh, actually do, nice. Okay, so from this point what you want to do is you want to place one block over there and then go down and then 3 to the right. Which gives us that shape. So also place a block over there. So let's leave it like that for now. Also on this side, what you also can do, which is a bit easier, is you place your clay over there. Then once again surround it, get rid of the clay. Then extend this one 3 times. It's pretty much the same thing as we did over here, but then on the other way. So that's now done as well. Then we go ahead and place one block over there, one block over there. Then extend it as well until you're at that line. So it's also over here. One over there and then. I think it's easier to do from the inside, by the way. That makes a bit more sense. So let me get a... Okay, there we go. Inside screenshot. Oh, this is way easier. So we are here at the moment. Okay, so over here at this point, what you want to do is place clay and then one quartz block. You want to extend it 3 times. 1, 2, 3. And then over here... Then you also want to extend that one. So let's do it over here as well. Extend that one, and then place 4 over here, which leaves it with this shape. Also just, by the way, this is a nice moment for you to pause the video, in case you didn't catch up with anything. All you need to do is then copy this, which you can see right now. Then we place 4 blocks over here. And also something over there, but I can't really see it, so give me a second. At least one over here, like that, and then this is gonna go, okay, 3 like that. Okay, so this is the shape, and over here as well, 1, 2, 3, 4, 3 like this, and then 1 over here. giving us that shape. Okay, so that's also done, which is nice. Then we go another layer down. So in order to do that, what you need to do, wait a second, is this right? Yes it is, okay, great. So we have that, and we've got this. So over here you want to extend it twice, then one over there. So what you basically need to do is you need to make that shape. And then we go ahead, place some quartz on those stone blocks, and then fill it up. Then the next layer is going to be three over here. Or not, no, it's not right. No, it's actually a full layer, I'm sorry. Like that. Just if you're wondering, this is 9 blocks wide. Then you go 1, 2, 3. 1, 2. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. And 1, 2, 3. Over as well. 3, 2, 3. Oh, sorry. 3, 3, 3. Alright. So then, what we need to do is we need to fill it up over here. Clay over there, black quartz. There we go. First layer is 5. Then there come 5 layers of 7. So this is the first one. Second one. Third one, which messed up totally. Fourth one. Fifth one. And then you go ahead and do 5 again. Alright, there we go. So this is the whole quartz part. Which looks pretty funny, to be honest. Look at that. Pretty strange. Now it's time for the clay and iron as well, by the way. Now it looks a bit complicated, but it's not that hard actually. So let's just go ahead and do it. First of all, let's do it from the top. You have, like, as you can see, iron, clay, iron. That's how you go all the way around. So let's go and do that. Just follow what I'm doing, because it's a bit hard to explain. You go one block to the front, then down, then there, then place like that, and as you can see that connects with the other iron, so let's do it on the other side as well, quickly. One block to the front, then just build above these iron blocks, which is like mainly the case for all those. Let's check where else that's the case. Let's do that. Okay, so let's go clay. Okay, then you want to place iron over there and over there and over there. On the other side as well. There, there, and there. Next thing, put some iron there. There, there, there. Check. There. There. No, it's not right, it's not right. Okay, so we have two over there. There, which is right, and that's also right, that's right. Okay, then we place this, so this is how it looks on that side, a bit hard to see or not. Anyway, I guess you guys can see from this point. Also on the other side, two over there, two over there, one over there, one over there. Then we go ahead and place 2, and then 1, alright, 2, 1, okay, that's the first layer of iron. Then we do a clay layer, which goes like this, first 7 blocks, then in front of the iron, mainly. Okay, so far it's all in front of, okay, so this part is all just placing clay in front of the iron. Then there's like one block, as you can see, which doesn't have iron, and that's where you want to make a little staircase shape. No, that's wrong. Sorry. No, it's not. By the way, then you want to go out a little bit, like this. Then you once again make a staircase shape. So let's do it on the other side. So you have staircase. Two blocks a little bit more to the outside, and then another staircase. All right. And then it's all building on top of the iron, so there, 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 there. I believe from this point, yeah, so I'll just component the iron, which is easy as you can see. Okay, there we go. Then the last layer, which is also iron. Oh, this looks way better already. First of all, just 7 blocks in front of this. By the way, instead of doing it like symmetrical, I just go all the way around this time. It's a bit easier, because otherwise I'm flying from the left to the right all the time. So then we place one over there, and then two like that. And over here it's in front of the clay. And over here it's a little bit more diagonal. Once again above it, in front of it. And then, oops, I'm sorry, there we go. So this is like 5 blocks going diagonal, as you can see. And from this point it is 1, 2, 3, 4 up. So first it was 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 diagonal up, and then 4 right up. Then we go 1, 2, 3, 4, yeah, like that. So 4 blocks diagonal up, and then just build one on top of that claim, one on top of that claim, one to the left and on top of that claim. So this is how this part looks. On the other side, one over there, two over there, one over there and one over there. Then we go a little bit diagonal, diagonal, diagonal. Then once again diagonal, diagonal. Then we go down 1, 2, 3. 4 blocks, as you can see, right, then 4 diagonal once again, so that means 1, 2, 3, 4, as you can see, and then it is 1 over there, 2 over there, and 1 over there. Okay, so there we go, that's the dish done. Now the only thing we need to do is make the actual, I don't know how you call this, but this power source thing inside of it, just like the point. Okay, so the first block has to be placed. Where is this exactly? You go to the middle of this little hole there. You go to the middle. There you go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Yeah, 7 blocks up. That's where you want to place your block. Also here from the middle. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 to the right. So we want to place your block. Then over there you see that exact same shape. And you want to place it in the middle over there. So there we go. Then for the left pole, it's going to be 2 up, then 1 diagonal, then 1 up to the right, 1 up to the front, 1 up to the right, and then 1 above that, then 2 diagonal. Okay, so this, okay, it looks very hard, but yeah, it's not, okay, let's show it you from this side. There we go. So let's do the same for the other one. 2 up, 1 diagonal, 1 to the left, 1 to the front, 1 to the left, and then diagonal to the left, 2. Right, there we go, this is how it looks. Then, we need any other blocks so far. It doesn't look like it's good. So then we have this one, then we go diagonal once again, 1 to the right up, and then 1 to the front, so here as well, diagonal, 1 to the left, and then 1 to the front, which leaves us with that, and they connect that. Alright, there we go. Then from this point it's way easier. It is, I believe, let me count it again, 1, 2, then diagonal, then 1, 2, 3, 4. So this one is 3, this one is 4, the next one is also 4, and then the last one is 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and as you can see that perfectly matches up with the other ones. Then we place a block of iron in the middle over here, with on top of that a redstone repeater. Oh, it actually looks that way. Then on the sides, oh, whoops, 2 levers pointing up, also over here in the middle one, and then a cobblestone wall over there. And there we go, that's the satellite done. which looks really epic, as you can see. So also feels really good to stand on top of this thing. It's actually really huge compared to the lab. Very nice, all those spear shapes. So this was the end of the episode. Next episode we're going to do player heads, as well as Xboxes for the PC. I've got some solutions, and then the last episode, which is 25, the one after that, I'm going to do a little bit of the biome around its place, and I'm going to tell you how to make the hills. I'm not going to make them detailed, but I'm just going to tell you a little bit how to make it here and there, roughly. And yeah, that's basically it, guys. So if you did enjoy this episode, make sure to give it a like, of course, and I will see you guys in the next episode. Later!